One could imagine asking a random individual on the street whether or not human beings, by and large, have biases, or if they're prejudiced. And that individual would probably say, yes, of course human beings have prejudice, of course they're biased. But how different would that be if you were to ask that same individual, do you think you're biased? Do you think you're prejudiced? Probably a different answer. And not an answer that would be limited by some brief soul-searching moment where he pauses and thinks about his own internal biases and prejudices. Probably not. He'll just be a lot more hesitant about it for rather obvious reasons. And human beings, indeed, have lots of biases, and they are prejudiced. Many of these are overt. Even more of them are covert. They are subconscious. We're not aware of them. And society in the West, and especially in the United States, has gone to great lengths to attempt to eliminate bias and prejudice, specifically in the form of discrimination. And by great lengths, I mean legally. They have attempted to do their best to prevent people from being discriminated against on the basis of unalterable traits. And most people think that's a good idea. And it runs the gamut from you're not allowed to discriminate on the basis of sex or gender, race or ethnicity, religion, at least in theory. And most people would say that's a good thing. And most people would also agree that for the most part, with the exception possibly of religion, these are traits, qualities that people have no control over. That is to say, they're unalterable. And so the basis of the West notion of curtailing discrimination, bias, and prejudice, whether it's legally or socially or both, is largely predicated on this idea that if a person can't help it, they shouldn't be discriminated against. Now, of course, as I mentioned at the beginning, there are many, many biases, and there's much prejudice against all sorts of things that we're not even aware of. Let's take a classic example. Think about height, specifically with respect to men. Now, not only in the mating market is there a severe bias, prejudice against shorter men, it's true in all social situations. There is that perception. It's a derivative of the halo effect that, indeed, taller men are simply more competent. Now, maybe many of them are, but that's not always the case. But the perception remains. And over a lifetime, a taller man can earn upwards of 15% more than a shorter man at the same occupation. And this is well documented, and yet there are no crusades to stop this. There are no laws on the books to prevent this. And height is a factor that most people could agree is not particularly controllable. And so we're working with a slew of unknown subconscious biases. And we show this prejudice in ways that we're not even aware of. As I mentioned earlier, the West, specifically the United States, has been quite good at eliminating, at least on legal books, the idea that discrimination can be a thing based on unalterable traits. But there is one trait that is largely unalterable, I'm going to argue, that is perfectly okay to be discriminated against. Everyone can show their prejudice in multiple directions even. And that trait is political view or political polarity. Now you might be thinking, how are one's political views somehow innate? How are they unalterable? Well, they're not as unalterable as some traits such as height or skin color, or gender. But the thing that scientists increasingly are discovering is that all human traits, including especially traits of personality, have a large heritable component, meaning that some of the variance we observe in individuals, maybe much of the variance we observe in individuals, is not due to systematic effects of the environment, but rather due to the influence of genes. Now, of course, environment helps to shape these things, but it's very unusual for individuals who come from a long, long conservative tradition, as an example, to completely turn the opposite direction. Now, they might do this temporarily, but as with all heritable traits, heritability increases with age, and usually people over time settle on something. If they're more left-leaning, more right-leaning, whatever. And inasmuch as at least some elements of this, and it depends on the study you look at, but a decent estimate, according to some studies, might be close to 50% of political views are heritable. That's not something people can do very much about. But the final, last prejudice that we're all allowed to exercise, especially if you're on the left, is prejudice towards people of opposite political polarity. Or, more likely, if you're on the left, against people on the right. Now, I think there are a number of reasons for this beyond the obvious that you simply don't agree with people and you don't want to see their views broadcast because you don't agree with them. And some of those reasons can be encapsulated in the idea that given the fact that most overt biases and the ability to exercise prejudice based on other traits, traits that are even more unalterable, given that that's been eliminated, a lot of people have resorted to something else. My interpretation of this is a wholesale consolidation of all the biases we typically manifest, unbeknownst to ourselves as individuals, thrown into this pot of political bias and then made to explode. Because everyone is allowed to show political bias, despite the strong evidence to suggest that much of political view and opinion is shaped by your genes. And I think in time, it will be shown that your genes shape your political views even more than we had previously thought. But because every other bias that we're overtly aware of and that have been displayed in history has been systematically eliminated, despite the claims of many people, and I think quite well. They've systematically eliminated these things. You're simply not allowed to discriminate on the basis of many different traits that are unalterable. This one trait, political view, political opinion, political polarity, however you want to describe it, you're allowed to go full hog on that. You're allowed to say, that person is an awful person because he thinks that about, take your pick, immigration or whatever. And it's interesting because if the data were better known, and if in time it were shown that heritability is an even greater component than previously thought, what would people do? Because here's the thing. The idea behind getting rid of discrimination officially in the books is not that people will completely cease in their biases or prejudice. Many of these things will be maintained. They're simply not allowed to exercise them in official capacity. But political bias and prejudice, which is to say, if you are prejudiced against somebody because you don't like his political views, well, you are allowed to discriminate on that basis. When it comes to hiring, for example, although it might not be explicit, you can definitely screen for things like that and say, I'm not going to hire you. Look at academia, particularly in the social sciences. It's been well recorded that people will screen for political view, and people who have right-leaning views, especially in the social sciences, will experience discrimination and prejudice. And that is considered perfectly okay. And so Western society, and specifically American society, has created a bubble in which all other forms of overt discrimination and bias and prejudice have been pushed out. But at the same time, the final bias, the last prejudice, is very much encouraged. Look at what has happened on multiple platforms. It's kind of obvious. You're allowed to discriminate against people, show prejudice, show bias. You're allowed to systematically get rid of people and all their social interaction. You're allowed to prevent people from getting a job simply based on their political view, something that has a large degree of innateness. And I think part of this, interestingly enough, is because we now see an intersection between political view and religious view. Politics has become so polarized and so religious that it's taken over the function for a lot of people of religion, of throwing people into different religious castes and discriminating against them on that basis. Because traditional religion is seen to be too sacred, so you're not allowed to officially discriminate against people for that. But politics, that's petty. That's mundane. That's menial. And so, of course, you can be as biased and prejudiced as you want against a person simply because he doesn't hold your views. And because politics has become enshrined as if it were a religion, and our political allegiances as well are viewed in a religious light, frankly speaking, the future is looking rather bleak. These are qualities people have that are partly innate, and yet people take no issue with discriminating on the basis of these qualities, and very, very intensely so, to the point where entire lives are ruined as a consequence. It's a very interesting turn in history. Not that this hasn't always been around, it has, it's just that in former times there were all kinds of overt discriminations and people would exercise them, whether justly or unjustly. But in the current year, 2021, things are looking quite different indeed. And if last year was any indication of how things are, then this year and future years will be an acceleration of that. As the new religion, politics, becomes more and more consolidated, and people dig their heels in even further, and the divisions sown become even greater. In any event, do you like the video? Please subscribe. Hit the bell icon to be informed of forthcoming videos. Share the video. As always, if I'm still alive, I'll check you out later. May the gods watch over you. Take care. If you liked this video, please like, share, and subscribe. And if you enjoy my content, please consider making a donation or becoming a patron. Thanks for watching.